which we had taken one pair of contrasting character for the cross. And we got some ratio as 3:1, that is 3 dominating characters, 1 recessive character, as well as 1:2:1. One was pure tall, 2 were hybrid tall, and 1 was pure dwarf. On the basis of this monohybrid cross, Mendel had put forward 2 laws, that is law of dominance, as well as law of purity of gametes, or law of segregation. This was the work till yesterday, correct? And then you all have solved one problem which I was not getting, of round and wrinkled. You all told me it is going to be the same ratio. It was perfect, correct? Now we are going to the something else, slightly higher than that. I am taking parent P1. Correct? A pure breeding or homozygous yellow and round seeded plant crossed with pure breeding or homozygous green and wrinkled seeded plant. Now if you go to see how many characters are there here, one is the color and one is the shape. So that means there are 2 different characters taken up over here. Yes or no? The 2 different characters are taken. So I am calling this cross as dihybrid cross. I call this cross as dihybrid cross because there are 2 different characters. Definition will come to it later. Agreed? Now what is the genotype of this parent? The genotype of this parent is yellow from father, yellow from mother because it is homozygous. It has got round from father, round from mother. Again, because it is homozygous. The same way the other one. It is green and it is wrinkled from father as well as mother. So it is homozygous for yellow, homozygous for round, homozygous for green, homozygous for wrinkled. But the 2 characters are together, so I am keeping it together only. Next, the genotype. We have done it. Now we have got to know the gametes of this. The gamete of this will be capital Y, capital R. Whereas for this, it will be small y, small r. The F1 generation will be capital Y, capital R, small r. That we can call it as hybrid or heterozygous. Yellow and round. We call this as hybrid or heterozygous yellow and round seeded plant. Now, this hybrid is undergoing selfing. So, I'll write it as parent P2. F1 multiplied by F1. Do I know the genotype of F1? Yes. Genotype of this F1 is capital Y, capital R, small r, crossed with capital Y, capital R, small r. We have to find the gametes of this. Now, simple terms I'm taking. There are 2 friends, your best friends, y'all are there. I'm taking capital R, small r, capital R, small r. I take myself and Sanket, sir, supposing. I can go along with one of your friends. I can go along with the second friend. Sanket sir can go along with the second friend, first friend, and as well as with the second friend. So these are the different combinations. Though we were together, you 2 friends, I and Sanket sir were together. But now we got segregated and we could merge it in a different way. So it was me, one of you, me and another friend. Same way, Sanket sir, one of you, Sanket sir, and one another friend. Correct or no? So we could have these many combinations over here. So the combinations were capital Y, capital R, that is one gamete. Capital Y, small r, that is the second gamete. Small y, capital R, that is the third gamete. Small y, small r, that is the fourth gamete. All these are the different combinations of one parent. The same way we have the different combinations of the other parent. Capital Y, capital R, 1. capital Y, small r, 2. Small y, capital R, 3. Small y, small r, 4. Correct? So from one parent, I'm getting these combinations. From the other parent also, I get the similar combinations. Because F1 is heterozygous. I have to know what is F2 then. F2 is all the male characters and female characters have to be present vertically downwards. Male have to go horizontally. So I will write the same gametes. Capital Y, capital R. Capital Y, small r. Small y, capital R. Small y, small r. Correct? The same way over here. Capital Y, capital R. Capital Y, small r. Small y, capital R. Small y, small r. Agreed? I've just written the gametes. Now, this is a checkerboard. If you go to see, we have got 4 gametes from father, we have got 4 gametes from mother. So 4 square is 16. So I get the 16 blocks over here. So I made the table of 5 rows and 5 columns. I've already made and kept. So that there is no confusion. I've put the numbers. The numbers are for some other reason. We will see it later. Correct? You all can see very clearly the numbers are there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 16. Tak. Each block is having a number on the right-hand side corner. Now, we are coming to the first block. Just see the first block. It is capital Y, capital R. Correct? So I will write over here capital Y, capital R, capital R. In appearance, this will be yellow round. In appearance, this will be yellow round. So I put one particular symbol for this yellow round. I am writing towards the right side also. Yellow round ka symbol I have taken it as. It should be capital Y dash, capital R dash. And the symbol for that is a star. Agreed? Go to the second block. It is capital Y, capital R, small r. Appearance mein what it will be? It will be yellow round. So I'm putting that same symbol. Go to the third block. It will be capital Y, small y, capital R, capital R. This also appearance way will be yellow round. Agreed? Go to the fourth one. Capital Y, capital R, small r. Yellow round. Next block. Capital Y, capital R, small r. Appearance way it will be yellow round. Now students, you all have to tell me now. It is capital Y, small r. What will this be in appearance?
Yellow.
It will be?
Yellow wrinkled.
Yellow wrinkled.
Yellow wrinkled.
Very good. So I am putting one symbol for this yellow wrinkled. I am putting a symbol for the yellow wrinkled as circle supposing. I am writing over here yellow wrinkled. Yellow wrinkled will be? Capital Y, small r. This can be omitted also. It could be capital Y or it could be small y. Correct? Y can be either capital or small. We are least concerned. But R has to be small in both the cases. Go to the next one. You have capital Y, capital R, small r. This will be what in appearance? Yellow round. Yes or no? Go to the third one. The next one. It will be capital Y, small y, small r, small r. This will be in appearance yellow wrinkled. Go to the next one. It is capital Y, capital R, capital R. It is yellow round. Go to the next one. It is capital Y, small r. It is again yellow round. Go to the third one. Students have to tell me now. It is small y, capital R.
Green round.
Green round, correct. It is green round. It is green round. So I'm putting another symbol for this. That is green round. The genotype over here will be small y, capital R. R can be either capital or small other one. Go to the next one. It is small y, capital R, small r. This also will be in appearance the same way. I'm letting you know. This will be green round. Next is y, capital R, small r. In appearance, this will be yellow round. Go to the next one. It is y, small r, small r. It is yellow wrinkled. Go to the next one. It is small y, capital R, small r. It's green round. What happened? What happened?
Ma'am, we weren't able to see. You did not place the camera at the right place.
Okay, so now you're able to see it? It's clear now?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So last one is what I forgot? Beech beech mein disturb kiya mere ko, main bhool gayi.
Green wrinkle.
Green wrinkle. Very good. Small y it is, my dear.
Okay, ma'am.
Green wrinkled.
Green wrinkled. Okay. So green wrinkled. There was one person who said, I am not getting it anything. I'll just revise it once again. Correct? I am taking a pencil and revising it. We have written the gametes. That is clear very here. All the gametes are clear how we got it. We had the F1 generation as hybrid capital y, capital R, small r. When these had to form the gametes, it could be one gamete capital Y, capital R, second gamete capital Y, small r, third gamete small y, capital R, fourth gamete small y, small r. That same thing was explained over here. I have written y, capital R, small r, capital R, small r. Capital Y, capital R, small y, capital R. The four gametes are very clear. Yes. The person who had written, I have not understood. Very clear? Till here? How the gametes have come? Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now, one side, if I'm having same gametes, if the genotype of the parent is similar, the same gametes will be repeated second time also. So, I have the parents' androsham ka gametes. I have the gynosham ka gametes over here. This Mohan sir, please speak out. She was writing over there. Mohan sir? Hello, Mohan sir? Mohan sir? You're writing something, speak it out. It will be faster solution. Hello? We have got the male gametes. We have got the female gametes. Mohan sir is not ready to talk or what? Excuse me. Then we are taking the F2 generation. We have taken all these gametes. One side, these gametes present horizontally. These gametes are going down vertically. Same way. Can you see? Same gametes are there. And they are present vertically downwards. Now I have tried to make the crosses. Capital Y, capital R. Means I've got capital Y, capital R. One capital R, if it is present, I'm going to get heterozygous yellow round. Whether it is homo or hetero, I'm least concerned. But it will be yellow round. So I put the star sign. I go to the second block. Capital Y, capital R. I'm getting yellow round. I go to the third block. Capital Y, capital R. Yellow round. I go to the fourth block. Capital Y, capital R. I am getting yellow round. Go to the fifth one. It is capital Y, capital R. Yellow round. Go to the sixth one. Capital Y, capital R. Means the character is changing now. So it will be yellow wrinkled. It will be yellow wrinkled. Go to the next one. capital Y, small y, capital R, small r. Yellow round. Capital Y, small r, yellow wrinkled. Third one. Capital Y, small r, yellow round. Capital Y, small r, yellow round. Small y, capital R. Capital R is indicating round, but small y is indicating green. So it will be green round. So we have changed the symbol over here. We have small y, capital R, small r. Again, green round. You take the last one. Capital Y, capital R, small r. It is yellow round. Next one. Capital Y, small r. Yellow wrinkled. Take the next one. Small y, small r. Green round. Take the last one. Small y, small r. Green wrinkled. Now count the number of stars over here. Count the number of stars over here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Count the number of yellow circles, orange circles. Count the number of orange circles. 1, 2, 3. Count the number of green circles.
3.
And count the number of purple circles.
1.
One.
So you are getting the ratio as 9:3:3:1. That is an external appearance ratio. Yes or no? That is the external appearance ratio. Agreed. Now I want to counter check this. Please pay attention over here now very carefully. How to counter check it? I have yellow, green. I have round, wrinkled. Correct? The ratio of yellow green monohybrid is 3:1. Of round wrinkled is 3:1. This you all did yesterday itself. Correct? Cross it. 3 3s are 9. You get yellow round. 3 1s are 3. That is green round. 1 3s are 3. That is yellow wrinkled. 1 1s are 1. That is green wrinkled. Have we got the ratio same way? 9:3:3:1.
Ma'am, I didn't get it. Can you explain it again?
Which one? This one?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. I'm also not getting it.
Okay. You know the monohybrid ratio, phenotypic?
Yes.
The phenotypic monohybrid ratio is 3:1.
Yes, ma'am.
And we have taken here two characters. One is color and one is shape.
Yes, ma'am.
Correct?
Yes,
so ma'am. I have taken the phenotypic ratio of the color over here, 3:1. Sorry, of the shape, sorry, color only over here, 3:1.
Okay, ma'am.
Can you make out yellow and green, 3:1? Then I've taken of the shape, 3:1, green, round and wrinkled.
Yes, ma'am.
Correct? Very clear now. I have taken the ratio of color 3:1. I have taken the ratio of shape 3:1. Monohybrid ratio. Correct, eh?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Abhe, isko multiply karo. 3 3s are kitna hota hai?
9.
So 9 is what? Yellow and round?
Yes, ma'am.
Correct?
Yes, ma'am.
3 1s are 3 is what? That is green and round?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Then 1 3s are 3 is what? Yellow and wrinkled?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Sir, 1 is what? Green and wrinkled?
Yes.
So this ratio I got 9:3:3:1. Is this ratio tallying with this? Am I getting
yes, ma'am.
9 round and yellow round? Am I getting 9 yellow, 3 yellow wrinkled?
Yes, ma'am.
Am I getting 3 green round and 1 green wrinkled?
Yes.
So it is tallying, yes, it is proper matching.
Okay. Yes.
To prepare this checkerboard, it at least takes 5 minutes from us. Ye sab combination lene ka, rakhne ka, चेकर बोर्ड बनाने के लिए टाइम लगता है करेक्ट वी चेक इट विद इन अ फ्रैक्शन ऑफ अ सेकंड जस्ट सी वेरी केयरफुली अगेन पे अटेंशन ओवर हियर प्लीज सी द मूवमेंट ऑफ दिस पेंसिल आई एम मूविंग द पेंसिल ऑल पासिंग थ्रू द ट्राइंगल आर स्टार्स दैट इज येलो राउंड करेक्ट
Yes.
All
passing this were yellow round. All at the vertices of this are yellow wrinkled. All at the vertices of the next one are green round. And the last one is separate. Once again. All passing through this big triangle are
येलो राउंड
सब स्टार्स है ना ये वाले सारे के सारे स्टार्स है ना येलो राउंड करेक्ट ऑल एट द वर्टाइसेस ऑफ दिस आर येलो रिंकल्ड ऑल एट द वर्टाइसेस ऑफ दिस आर ग्रीन राउंड
यस मैम
द लास्ट वन इज केप्ट सेपरेट इट विल हार्डली टेक अ फ्रैक्शन ऑफ मी टू
ग्रीन रिंकल्ड
Last one is green wrinkled, correct? So it only took any time for me to check it. Now I would like to find the genotypic ratio of this. I can say the genotypic ratio is 1:2:1:2:4:2:1:2:1. As a layman, you might be thinking I have mugged it up. No dear, don't have to mug it up anything. See again, I'm doing here with pencil. That's the reason why I kept the space over here. 1:2:1. You had pure breeding yellow. You had hybrid yellow. You had pure green. ये mono hybrid का genotypic ratio था आपने पास?
Yes.
Okay. ये second mono hybrid का genotypic ratio है अभी? Yellow. Sorry, round. हाइब्रिड राउंड एंड रिंकल्ड बराबर है अभी मैं इसको मल्टीप्लाई करती हूँ पहले ये 1 को इससे मल्टीप्लाई करो तो आई विल गेट 1 1s are 1 दैट इज येलो राउंड 1 2s are 2 दैट इज हाइब्रिड येलो होमोजाइगस राउंड 1 1s are 1 दैट इज ग्रीन राउंड यस आई एम पुटिंग पर्पसली दिस Big line so that you should understand what I've done. So, but it is 2. Now you multiply 2 by all these things. So it is 2 1s are 2. That is what mono homozygous yellow heterozygous round is 2 4. That is heterozygous yellow heterozygous round. Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Then 1 1 2 1s are 2. That is Homozygous green, heterozygous round.
Yes.
Again a big line. Now I have to multiply this 1 with all of them. So 1 1s are 1. It is homozygous yellow, homozygous wrinkled.
Yes.
1 2s are 2. It is heterozygous yellow, homozygous wrinkled. 1 1s are 1. It is. 1 1s are 1. It is green as well as wrinkled homozygous. Correct? Now, if you would like to check it, just check it. Homozygous yellow round, there is one block. So, this is this block. I will take a red pen to show it. So, one block is over. Agreed?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes?
Yes.
Okay. Now, go to the second one. It is 2. Capital Y, small y, that is heterozygous yellow, homozygous round. Where you are getting this? Homozygous round. Homozygous round. Heterozygous yellow and homozygous round. Oh. As well as 9th block, check it.
Yes,
yes, ma'am.
Okay. So first, this is only first. This is 3rd and 9th. Yes or no? Go to the next one. Go to the next one. It is homozygous green, homozygous round. Homozygous green, homozygous round. Here it is there.
Yes, ma'am.
Can you see?
11.
Okay, so I have to take that block. 11th one. Go to the next one. It is homozygous yellow, heterozygous round. There are two such blocks. Homozygous yellow, heterozygous round. One. Homozygous yellow, heterozygous round. Two. Getting it? Two and five. Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
Hello, two and five. Next, you have four. Heterozygous yellow, heterozygous round. Just see diagonally. Fourth block. Fourth block. Seventh block.
10 and 13.
10th block. 10 and 13. 4, 7, 10 and 13. So 4, 7, 10, 13. Agreed?
Yes, ma'am.
Go to the next one. It is homozygous green and heterozygous round. Homozygous green and heterozygous round. 12 and 15.
15. Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So 12 and 15. Next you have is homozygous yellow, homozygous wrinkled. That is
six.
Block number six.
Very six,
good.
Yes, ma'am.
Heterozygous yellow, homozygous wrinkled.
It is
block number eight.
Yes. Yes,
and
ma'am.
Block 14?
14.
Yes, ma'am.
14.
Yes, ma'am.
So it is 8 and 14. And the last one is the 16 left out.
16.
We have considered all the blocks. Sabne red tick mark hai. Number ke yahan pe?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Apna ratio sahi hai. Apna ratio sahi hai. The ratio is now, I'm orally multiplying it. Multiply first 1 by 1 is to 2 is to 1 ko first multiply by 1. Next time you multiply by 2. Next time you multiply again by 1. So how it comes to? It comes to 1 is to 2 is to 1. Is to 2 is to 4 is to 2. Is to 1 is to 2 is to 1. That becomes the genotypic ratio of a dihybrid cross. Once again, I'm multiplying this by 1, then by 2, and then by 1.
1.
So if I'm multiplying by 1, I'll get 1 is to 2 is to 1. When I multiply by 2, I get 2 is to 4 is to 2. When I multiply by 1 again, I'll get 1 is to 2 is to 1. So my ratio is now 1 is to 2 is to 1 is to 2 is to 4 is to 2 is to 1 is to 2 is to 1. Is it clear to everyone?
Yes, ma'am. It's clear.
Very clear? Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Now, I would like to name this cross. We have named it. I would like to describe, define that particular cross. Correct? How will I define this cross now? Dihybrid cross. Here, how many characters I've taken? When?
Two, ma'am.
Correct. When two pairs of contrasting characters. When two pairs of contrasting characters are taken into consideration. Are taken into consideration for a cross. The cross is
dihybrid
cross. Dihybrid cross.
Ma'am.
Correct. Aji.
The yes, time sir? For this lecture meeting has ended. You can join with the same link again.
Okay.
Everybody
आपका लफड़ा होता है मेरे को ओके नहीं ओके